and live it. So I'm saying, to get to greatness, you have to find your path, believe in your path, and live it. Now, how do you find your path? You may not know yet. There's many times in life that, you know, sometimes just at the beginning you like certain things, and certain things affect your life. You may not know exactly what you want to do, but your path is your path. You know what I was? When I was 12 years old, I was in English class, and my teacher, her name was Mrs. Lane, she started teaching us about different Africans, different African American history, different people that have affected our history and our country that are of African descent. Well, I learned about a story. She taught us about a story about this young man from Chicago named Emmett Till. And Emmett Till was a young man that came home on the south side of Chicago. And this is during the 50s when this story took place. He went to visit his family down in Mississippi in 1955. Now, he's coming from Chicago, the north, which is still prejudice, but it's a little different than the south. The south is a lot rougher. Well, it was one afternoon, and he and his cousins, 14-year-old boy, went to the candy store. When they went to the candy store, Emmett Till whispered at a white woman. And when he whispered at her, she was offended. She didn't say anything at that moment, but she went back and told her husband and his friends. And they came looking for Emmett Till because he whispered at a white woman. And when they found him, they went to Emmett Till's family's house where he was staying for the summer with his cousins and his uncle. And they took him out of the house and they beat him. And they beat him to death and threw him in the river. Now, they didn't find Emmett Till's body until days later. And when they did, his mother decided when they shipped his body back to Chicago to have an open casket funeral. His head is full up because of being in that river and the way they beat him. His head is full up about as big as his podium. And when I seen these pictures, I was scared. I couldn't believe that the hate could do that to someone. And I stopped realizing I was a part of me in a way, because I was just a young man from Chicago at the age of 12 reading this story. Well, around that same time, 12 years old, I also was a ball boy for the Chicago Bulls, which was a cool job and everything, you know. But being a ball boy, I worked for the visiting team's locker room. I would have to travel in this tunnel under the stadium to go back to the home team's locker room to take all the equipment back. And I found out about the story about Emmett Till. When I was going under this tunnel, I would always run under the tunnel because I felt like Emmett Till was chasing me. So, I mean, this happened like multiple games, at least 8 games. I was going under the tunnel, running, pushing the equipment and everything. Well, one day one night I decided to be the black guy in the scary movie and just stop. It was like, what you want with me? I felt the spirit. It was the spirit of Emmett Till. And I stood still and I just listened, and there was no more fear inside of me. And what the spirit said to me was, you're greater. You're greater than what you know right now. There's something inside you that's great that you have to give to the world. And I'm looking around, I didn't see anybody, but I heard it and I felt it. And that day, that night, I knew it was something inside me that I had to give to this world, something to contribute to this world, that was greater than I knew or believed. Well, I didn't know what that was. And around that same age, I was into different things. I was, you know, going to school, playing ball. In school, I was a pretty good student. I would do well. I loved like math, science, and it so happened in my math class, I had a great teacher named Mr. Brown. Just saw him yesterday, like, oh, in a long time I hadn't seen him, but I saw him and this man warmed my heart. Mr. Brown was one of the greatest teachers I had. But for some reason, when I was in his class, I marching past. I did it to get attention at the time. Like, ladies, I know that ain't the way to do it now.
Express.
That's my path. Well, I was 12 years old, I didn't know that was my path. But I remember writing my first rap with my cousin. We were in Cincinnati, and it was right after our 7th grade. It was our 7th grade, summer going into 8th grade. And he was like, hey, let's write a rap. I was like, all right, cool, cool. And we sat there in his bedroom room. And at his desk, I remember writing my first rap. Actually, I'm gonna kick you out of some of those first raps. This is the first rap. I said, well, let me tell you about a trip, a time ago. I was going there to run a cold-blooded show. When I was there, I saw some people chilling too. They called themselves the Bond Hill Crew. That's the Max, Romeo, and Master E. All of the Bond Hill Crew, wrapped into a T. I asked them, could they rock with me? That's all I remember, y'all.